I know that this knowledge that I'm producing is actually being used to make it more comfortable here in the desert for people.
Comfort hard to come by in this triple digit heat that we experience in the summer, but new this morning, ASU has MaRTy to help out.
MaRTy is a heat robot monitoring the impact extreme heat does have on our bodies and also how shade can make us feel so much better.
Megan Thompson rolling along with the team behind it.
It's probably the most basic conversation starter. Wow, such interesting weather we're having.
This is like the easy way to get in touch with people.
But when you combine weather and a contraption like this, Florian Schneider can't get the questions and the stares to stop.
You have adults coming at any age. They're interested in that because you investigate their neighborhood, basically.
Schneider, a PhD student at Arizona State University, using this device called MaRTy, which collects data to help understand the struggles our bodies are feeling in our extreme weather.
We do have several sensors. So for example, this sensor is collecting air temperature data and relative humidity.
Schneider, coming from Germany to help MaRTy's creator from construction, Associate Professor Ariana Medell.
What we can do is we can identify areas where a lot of people walk and then specifically shade those areas.
Medell is showing us the thermal mapping MaRTy has come up with so far.
Blue is the coolest, and then green and yellow is like medium and red is hot.
MaRTy, born back in 2016, a mix of Amazon ordering and high-powered technology.
I wanted to have something that's mobile, something that I could move around. It's something that's easy to handle and that's not too bulky.
And it works to understand which shade type may help most with your comfort in the sun.
MaRTy measures mean radiant temperature, which is the radiation that hits your body from all sides, and mean radiant temperature, short, is MRT. So that's why MaRTy is called MaRTy. It's kind of like MRT.
They've been working on research throughout Tempe, even taking MaRTy on the road to Tucson and California, starting a study called 50 Grades of Shade, their research ramping up as the temperatures do too.
Now we're trying to rank those shade types to see which shade is most effective and could be used as a replacement for trees in areas where you cannot plant trees.
And Megan joining us live right now from Tempe. So Megan, with this research, have they been able to uncover what is the best and worst options when it comes to shade?
Nick, so far they say umbrellas, they are the worst because it pretty much radiates that heat back onto a person's head. As for the best, they say overpasses or awnings, those types of things. That's what they're looking to put into place, that infrastructure where they can't actually plant trees. They hope that this research will be able to be used in city planning for the future.
And not just here, in other really hot cities across the world, I'm sure. Megan, what a cool project, all of it happening right here in the Valley. We appreciate that.